You know, we often talk about waves in the atmosphere. It's just like waves in the ocean. It generates energy. The atmosphere is fluid as well as just like the ocean. So your waves of energy have been just coming in, well, no pun intended, literal waves over the last several days. And the next little wave here is across parts of Utah. So you can kind of see that right there. That is going to start to really level back out as we move through the next 24 hours. And we will start to get kind of a ridge of high pressure building into the region. We're having, looks like some technical difficulties here. So hang with me. There we go. I think our system is a little sleepy as well. It's probably the weather. You'll notice, though, as we move through Wednesday, look at this little ridge of high pressure building in. This is some good news. Okay, we're going to ride this wave. We're going to get excited about it because it means some sunshine is going to return. And we need all the good news we can get right now. Temperatures are going to start to warm back up as well. Not so much on Wednesday. We're going to have to wait a little bit longer. I think Thursday we're going to have an abundance of sunshine, but some locations across the eastern plains will start to get a peak of sun on Wednesday. But we are more so going to feel that warmer air and that beautiful sunny sky, start to experience that by Thursday. For now, that wave of energy is propagating across the state, and that is triggering some passing showers and even a few snow showers across parts of the high country. So as we move through the overnight hours tonight, you'll notice those showers start to settle south and east and kind of clipping La Junta areas back into the southeastern plains, and a few little snow flurries in the Sangre de Cristos overnight tonight. Otherwise, we are looking for cloudy skies to stay in the forecast. It'll still be a dismal start tomorrow morning, and maybe some areas here of some pretty patchy dense fog, especially across southern sections of Lincoln County and areas in eastern El Paso County. Then we'll start to see some peaks of sun throughout the afternoon across the eastern plains and eastern sections of El Paso County, but most of I-25 and our local mountain cities actually stay mostly cloudy for tomorrow afternoon, then completely clearing out just after sunset tomorrow. So we'll really have to wait until Thursday for that abundance of sunshine. Any snowfall that occurs will be very light and confined to those higher terrain areas well west of I-25. So you're looking at nothing here that's going to cause any widespread travel impacts. However, you may have to watch elevated surfaces west of I-25 early tomorrow morning if those surfaces are still damp, so bridges and overpasses. The fog here could be pretty treacherous, especially across Pumpkin Center and I-70 up into northern Lincoln County and parts of Pueblo between 6 and 9 a.m. in the morning. That would really reduce your visibility to about a quarter of a mile in some locations. I still think we're going to have some areas of patchy dense fog here in El Paso County. Don't think this model is picking up on it very well, but all that to say, may have to kick on those low beams tomorrow morning and allow some extra time to get to work. Now, I think this model is a little bit optimistic with sunshine returning tomorrow. With temperatures back into the 50s, I still think we're going to be in the 40s tomorrow with some partly to mostly cloudy skies, and the 40s there in the Wet Mountain Valley in Westcliff, and low 50s there in Pueblo. We will get some sunshine across the eastern plains. A few peaks of sunshine that'll help bump our temperatures into the 40s and 50s for the afternoon hours. And look at this. We've got some sunny days ahead, and we are looking at increasing sunshine for the end of the week into the upcoming weekend as temperatures soar back to around 60 degrees. So it is going to be a dry and bright stretch of weather ahead. We're going to be blinded by the light, if you know what I mean. I may have to just remember those sunglasses on the way out the door on Thursday. Canyon City, highs in the 40s and 50s tomorrow. 10% chance of a stray shower in the morning. Otherwise, it will be dry by the afternoon, but we look for that ample sunshine on Thursday, and that will help warm the surface back into the 60s, which is close to where we should be for this time of year. And alas, just in time for the weekend to get out and enjoy the weather, you're going to be able to do so both Saturday and Sunday with highs steady in the low 70s. Back to you guys.
Loving the chances of that. All
right. Blinded by the light.